Hello, my name is Jennifer Wagner, and I'm your son or daughter's 10th grade American Literature English teacher. I truly look forward to working with your son or daughter this semester, and I think we're going to have a great time together. I really look forward to having everybody back 4 days a week in February and hopefully 5 days a week in March. I normally mainly teach 9th grade. I've taught 10th grade before, and then this year I picked up two 10th grade sections again because I was hoping, like through the pandemic, that I would have some of the students that I taught in 9th grade back again in 10th grade. And that has happened, and that's been a very cool experience to have some students 2 years in a row. And I look forward to meeting like all my new students also that I didn't teach in 9th grade. I like teaching American literature. I like teaching the lower grades, like 9th grade and 10th grade. A little bit about me. Lancaster County born and bred. I grew up in the southern end of the county. I went to Penn Manor High School, then I went to not very far to Millersville for English education. My first job was in Baltimore County, Maryland. I stayed down there for a short time and then came back home to Calico Middle School, where I taught for 6 years and then moved over to the high school. And I've been super happy here at the high school. There's lots of opportunities for teaching different electives and again, changing your grade level a little bit just to mix things up. A little bit about the American literature course. As far as literature goes, the main thing we'll read together will be The Great Gatsby, which is a great book, and my students generally do like it. We will do a classic novel also of the students' choosing. So I'll give them a list of a variety of classic novels, and they'll pick one book off that list to read. We'll read choice books, we'll read poems, we'll read short stories. Right now we're reading some documents. We're looking at the Declaration of Independence and looking at like the persuasive techniques used in it to try to build towards a better bigger project down the road where the students will use those persuasive techniques in creating, developing, and marketing a product of their own. We'll have some vocabulary. The main vocabulary that we have in this class are literary terms lists because students will take the Keystone exam at the end of this course. So in this course, I'm not like Keystone exam, but we are kind of like quietly like making sure and reinforcing the concepts that students need to be successful on the Keystone. So most of our vocab lists are literary terms just to get them fresh in the students' minds and floating around in there so that when they're asked about them on the Keystone exam, they'll be like, oh yeah, I know what you're talking about. We will do a lot of different writing. The main focus in 10th grade with writing is more literary analysis. In 9th grade, it's more five paragraph essay type writing with a little bit of literary analysis. 10th grade, we pretty much solely focus on literary analysis. I also have the students do some creative writing also because I think that's very important also to the students. Research, we should get to a like mini research paper on The Great Gatsby, and we should get to a bigger research paper on the classic novel that the students read. With hybrid learning and with the school year not being a typical normal year, we will see how far we get, but we should at least get to The Great Gatsby like mini research paper. And then just some class policies. But again, this year I've shown my students a lot of grace, and they've shown me a lot of grace with technology too, which I am grateful for. Typically, I assign homework and in a college prep class, I'll accept it 1 day late for half credit. But again, if there are extenuating circumstances, I will work with a student. If a student is absent, they can message me to see like what they missed, and I'll let them know. If a student is quarantined, I'll put up work for them every single day. No worries about that. If a student would miss a test or a quiz, they should try to make it up within a week. But again, extenuating circumstances, like I am understanding of that. And just in general, I'm just looking forward to having a good semester with your son or daughter, and I think it'll be a great experience. If you should need to contact me for any reason, please feel free to either call or email, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you.